Hello everyone, welcome to Sweetie Speaks official YouTube channel. Today we are going to learn how to write external constraint. External means that the constrained body is not present inside the class, just like external function or task. Let us see this example first. I have a class external constraint. In this I have one random here, if you see, I have a rand operator and I have two random integers a and b. Now we had discussed in system Verilog tutorial series. In case you did not go through that series, please go through that first, because there we have discussed a lot of data types which form the basis of any system Verilog concept. The system Verilog tutorial series is present on same YouTube channel, Sweetie Speaks Official. There we have discussed about a data type called as integer. Integer is by default signed. Signed means you will have negative as well as positive values. So I have random integer, two integers a and b. And I am saying I have a constraint a greater than b. But the body of this constraint is not present inside the class. I have just said that there is going to be a constraint. Now, if you see, the body of this constraint is present outside the class. Here the class has ended, and outside the class, I am saying that this constraint, which I am declaring now, belongs to a class called as external constraint. And the constraint name was a greater than b. The body of this constraint is like this. A should be greater than b. After that, I am creating a module to test this external constraint class. So I have a module test external constraint, in which I have initial block. Inside initial, I am creating an object of class external constraint. We are calling new. This is a constructor. In case you did not go through system Verilog series, where we have discussed about classes, constructors, objects, please go through it. That series is also present on same YouTube channel, Sweetie Speaks Official. The name of the series is System Verilog. After creating an object of external constraint, we are randomizing this object 25 times. And finally, I'm displaying the values of A and B. According to the constraint, the value of A should be greater than B. I have already run this example. Let us see whether the outputs are as expected. I have said A should be greater than B. Is A greater than B? In this case, A is positive, B is negative. So of course, A is greater than B. Now let us see an example where both values are negative. See, here both values are negative, but B is less. If you see, the minus value is more here and minus value is less here, which means B is less than A, or A is greater than B. Like this, you can analyze all the outputs, and in all scenarios, you will find that A is always greater than B. See here, both positive values, and here also A is greater than B. This is how you can declare the constraints externally. When is it useful? Say, for example, while creating a class, you know there are going to be constraints which you will need, but at this moment you are not sure what should be the body of that constraint. In such instances, using external constraints is going to help you. To stay tuned to such quality content on VLSI, please subscribe to Sweetie Speaks official YouTube channel. Thank you.